Hello, this is Aeon, and I'm going to be doing a little tutorial for the Monster Planet Maker. This is the main screen for it, etc. This is it. It's still not totally done yet, but it is good enough to be called beta, I think. And I'm going to be releasing it today. So here's how to actually use it, because it can be a little counterintuitive at some points, like every single 3D editing program out there. You can hold down the right mouse button and move your camera around. That's how you do that. You can also select parts just by clicking on them. And you can add parts by coming over to the Parts tab, clicking on a part, and you move it around. You don't have to hold the mouse button down, and then you click, and it puts it down. That's how that works. Let's see what's next. Selecting parts, I did that. Okay, moving with the gizmo. Okay, this is the gizmo. And you can see it lights up as you go over it, so you know that you're clicking it. And you click it down and hold, and you move it back and forth. And you can move things around. And up and down. And you can rotate them. Like this. There's also a difference between the object position and rotation and each of these, which are little sculpting bones that are in the object. And you can click one of these and move it, and you can actually change the shape of the object and rotate it. So you can make all sorts of different shapes. The one thing to know, though, is that this bottom bone and this one, oh, see, all these are all connected here. So when I move this one moves. They're all linked up, and it should be pretty obvious which ones have what kind of links where. So, but the difference is that this one you can change, you can move the base position, and you can also move the base bone position. So if I move this over there, and then I select back onto the object, the gizmo goes back to where the actual object's center is. So you can change the center of an object and move it around that point as well, which is fairly useful for making stuff. And you can put it back. Careful. Right, almost. So, there's that. What's next? Sliding. You can slide parts around again. So if you take an object and you click on it and you hold down for a minute, it'll let you slide it around. And you can drag it over everything and you can put it wherever you want. You can also copy parts by holding down your control key and clicking on it again and holding it down. And then when it copies the part, you can let go of the control key and move that around. And you can put that on things. So you can copy parts and make a ton of things. You can also, when you put things on top of another part and you let go, now this is connected to that. So if I move this one around, that one goes with it. And if I rotate, I guess I got that bone way off. So, oh, that's right. Also, moving the bone around, it doesn't connect to the bones. It connects directly to the object. So that can be a little confusing if you don't get that. But if you play around with it, it'll make sense. So, that's how you connect objects, and then you can connect, like, this one to there, and then move this one around, and then move this one to get this one around, and that way you can make limbs and arms and objects and things that are all interconnected. Plus, if you control-click and copy the base object, it copies everything that's connected to it as well. So, really cool way to make all sorts of stuff. If you select an object and you press delete, it deletes everything that's attached to it. So that's also very useful. Okay. Next, we did copying parts. Connecting parts. Okay. Control. Okay, there's also the control panel. That's over here. And this lets you get a little bit more precise movements. So you can select something and move it a whole 25 distance to a new spot. In X, Y, and Z, and these should line, they do line up with their little gizmo parts. You can also rotate. And you can also scale, although it only works on bones, and it is somewhat broken, and that's not my fault. But, and I won't go and explain it, but it does work, and you can scale things. If you scale all of them at once, it'll make everything fine, but if you start scaling in one direction, it's probably going to screw these things up eventually. It's going to kind of make that funny. just going to have to deal with. So you see how that rotating spot, you don't expect it to rotate. That's what happens when you scale things because of this complicated math that I don't want to get into. Okay. Next. Materials. Materials are cool. Go to the material tab, and you can you can get and set the material. So if you click on something, this selecting the objects in here, you can click on multiple things and set multiple materials at once. You click on it again, it deselects them. So I clicked on this, I do get, and it will get that object material. You can go through and set all these different kind of textures, right? And then you do set. When you get it the way you want, you can change all these specular levels, and glow and emissive and everything. You can do sets. You can make all sorts of different types of stuff. Also, this gives you a texture scaling, so you can put like 4x4